You're watching Minister's Material with Prophet Emmanuel Makandiwa.
That way it will help you, even if you're going to have 90 members in your church. They are solid people. They are solid people.
It's very prophetic, man of God.
Very, 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 very strong. There are people that really believe in what you're doing. Those people can actually die for you. You see, it's because you're working in a certain area. Those people that are, the reason why they are coming to you, they have seen you. God has spoken to them about you. They are so confident. But as men of God, sometimes you get to a point where you feel like, I'm left behind because others are now prophesying, they are now doing this and so on. So, if I can also move into that. That is okay. I'm not saying there's a problem with that. But you also have to appreciate that there are people that have already chosen you even before you started prophesying. There are people who like you the way you are that you might lose when you start prophesying. So I'm not saying stop declaring that people are free. Declare. But once you have declared, advise them to stay. Tell them, now that you are free, I want to see you. Next service, be here. We have to talk about what has been happening with you. You start feeding them and giving them information. That is the deliverance that actually works for our people. If we are just to enjoy deliverances that are taking place and so on and so on and so on in Africa, demons are here. We have demons. We have demons, even if you are to pray and ask God for the number of the demons. Ask God, how many demons are out there? My God. Then you realize that I think we need a different approach. Looking at the number of demons. Imagine if you can gather 20 people and 16 of them are manifesting. The rate at which demons are possessing people and the rate at which we are delivering them, we are too slow. There has to be a better approach. This laying on of hands and so on and shouting and screaming and so on, we are way behind. Imagine. And by the time you finish with all those 16, 30 minutes after the service, 14 of them are possessed once again. So what are we doing? What are we doing? If I am to select some people right now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 people come here, you can see deliverance taking place. But why am I keeping them? Am I allowing demons to be here? I'm not allowing demons to be here. But the same approach, there is a scripture that says, and he healed them with his word and delivered them. Listen, that's why I always say, of all the people that were close to Jesus, they all received their deliverance, but it was in a different fashion. It was in a different fashion. All of them were delivered, but the nature, the kind of deliverance that they got was not like the deliverance that the rest of the people got from Jesus. Also, when you have people that are suffering in your ministry, you have also to know whether it is it is a demon doing that. Or there is something that there is another interpretation to what is happening. You have to know, just like I was looking in the Bible, I looked at the life of Abraham, Sarah. Hannah. All these people were candidates for deliverance. If Abraham was to come to our church, he was going to be in trouble. I was going to make him fast and start the session and ask him to come back again for another session of deliverance. And yet there was no demon. So some of the people that are barren now in our ministries, we have to establish. That's where now the prophetic comes in. You look at a person, look at the situation. You have to get an interpretation which is accurate. What really is happening to this person? And God can speak to you. When we get to the prophetic, I will talk about that. How you can start helping people by giving them accurate information. Accurate information. It helps because it's not something that we are trying to bring in. It was brought in by the Holy Spirit, the prophetic ministry. It helps people. At least somebody will know what is happening and why it is happening and what the person should do. A person who is not a prophet can pray for a person with a demon and give conditions. Go and do this. Go and pray. Go and do this. Not because the Lord is telling him, but because of just experience. He just tells you something that you have to just do on a daily basis, which is obvious, maybe which is scriptural, not because God is talking to him directly. So he's giving every sick person the same medication. That's where the prophetic comes in now. You have a person with a demon of anger, and the Lord speaks to you and you give him his own prescription. You go to the next person with a demon of anger. You give him a different prescription. Why? Because the rhema has to be tailor-made to suit that individual. So the prophetic should never be underestimated. It is needed. But when I start now taking you into the prophetic, even before you are called prophet, these things are so easy. Just like I can send you. I can and you can start prophesying without even being called a prophet. And people begin to wonder. But what makes it stay is when you continue connecting and feeding from the same source where you got it from. And then it will settle. So I like your approach, prophecy, deliverance, bringing them together. And it says if certain people are not really benefiting from that, maybe it's because the deliverance is not really happening, or the prophecy there is not even prophecy. It's just because I'm called by that title, so I have to perform like a prophet. But if you are really a prophet, you can declare a person free, and the person is free indeed. But if he goes away right away, the demon can still come back. And you find him being delivered again by another man of God. And that other man of God will be very proud. And saying, you see, that one could not help you but me. And when he finishes with him, take him back again, you see that demon also coming out again. So you can only deliver a person up to a certain level. Because God has given you that power. You can do that. But if I pray for anyone right now, okay, let's say I'm here, I'm teaching you and so on. and a man of God is waiting for you outside. And he calls you after this session and said, you have got a demon, let me prove it to you. And then he prays for you, a demon comes out and he's asking you, so what was the man of God doing about it? You were going there, he never prayed for you, this demon never came out, now you are free. And you come to me and you tell me that this is what happened to me. I was prayed by that man of God and a demon came out. Why were you leaving me like that? Then I'll ask you, so are you now free? And you say, now I'm free. And I'll say, okay, now let me pray for you. You'll see it coming out. It's not because I was ignoring that demon. I was preferring another formula that works for you. You realize that most of those people, when a demon entered, they never fell. They never screamed. They never rolled on the floor. When it entered, it can also live the same way. When light is introduced into the life of the person, the same way it entered, it will live quietly. And that kind of deliverance, that's what I prefer. That's what I prefer. That's what I prefer. I thank God because I'm able to talk to you about these issues, which I can also do. If I couldn't do this, some people would say, ona manjo. And that's what I was saying on Tuesday. I said, the Holy Spirit said to me, if you see the anointing of the person is known, not by the people it attracts, but the anointing is known by the quality of people that it keeps. So you have to look at that. You don't look at the people that are coming. No. Look at the quality that the anointing is keeping. There's a difference between coming and keeping. You will see that when you start being used by God in that area, you have to have a special way of inviting quality people. You have to have some people working on the ground who are supposed to work hard in inviting people to come. Quality people, you have to invite them. They will not just come. If you're doing that and so on and so on, and people are vomiting, urinating and so on, a person of quality, you actually have to invite him. If you see a person, a dignified man sitting there, he's invited. You just don't know. He was begged, please come. But they will never stay. They will never stay. I'm telling you. What I'm giving you now is ministry. This is ministry now. And if you were doing that before and people were falling and miracles were happening every, when you stop doing that, you realize that maybe your numbers might go down. You're not losing people, you're losing demons. You are actually delivering your church. You are delivering your ministry. Demons, I'm telling you this, you see, the more you cast them, the more you attract them. Don't get into the gifts just because you want to increase your numbers. Most of these gifts, they are just there to convince a person that is coming for the first time, so that he knows God is in this place. When he makes a decision to stay, then you move on to the next stage. You start grooming the person, teaching the person. And then if you see that kind of a thing,